selling classified United States documents to the Soviet Union.
Your father is a spy for the Soviet Union!
All right, Mom. Ivan isn't reading our minds. He's reading our mail.
You can take over the business. I'll teach you everything I know.
To a wonderful trip.
Lachaim.
Lachaim!
We have no choice but to hijack this ship.
If we are attacked tonight, you will all die. British, American, Jews.
Syria!
That makes you the richest little girl in the world.
Do you know, Barbara, people will always be fascinated by you.
You're a hottie, and you're to act like one.
I am.
The only girl in the world who can buy anything on anyone. And she can't hold on to any of it!
When you're ready to be put in the tower, I'll put you in one. Don't worry.
You think I would have come here and embarrassed myself if I knew you had a wife?
Last time we blew up 7 ships with 12 of us. This time I want twice as many men. I intend to destroy that harbor, sir.
A prudential savings plan could help cover all the demands your children make of you in years to come. Whatever their ambitions in life, you want to be with Prudential.
I'm just over the rim now, to the west, Gustavholm, but in front of me, the spectacular Mount Farell Glacier. Since the Ice Age, this mighty glacier has gouged its unstoppable path to the Straits of Denmark, where it breaks off into the sea to form massive Carlsbergs.
Oh, God.
Sorry.
Well, the footprint's a problem.
Just wait at the bottom. There's a good chap.
I feel a complete amateur.
No, honestly, you mustn't.
Who on earth gives you the biggest welcome?
The wildest time!
With peace and quiet.
With thrills!
And spills! There's only one place on earth it could be. Elton Towers, where wonders never cease.
A cool taste of paradise. Real cream ice cream. With tender, luscious coconut. 1,000 flakes, snow white, snow cool. In a real milk chocolate shell. Bounty ice cream paradise.
So I just popped in the post office when he comes in for a passport. Next thing, she's in getting traveller's checks. 3 guesses who'll be rubbing her suntan island.
Yes,
and her with her child benefit just increased, if you catch my drift. Then young Wayne's in for a tax disc, cashing his gyro.
He wasn't.
Of course, then Mrs. Perkins says she's in for a refund on her prescription charges, because she's had problems with her. I mean, I'm not one for gossip. Oh, you're not. Only I just popped into the post office for a stamp. It's amazing what you can pick up there.
Just look at all that grounding grime.
I can't see anything shifted in that.
Don't tell me. These stubborn stains are impossible.
Sorry, love.
This grease, it hasn't budged.
It just never gets deep down clean, does it?
Typical. They've never heard of Shell Advanced Petrol.
Yeah. It's got special detergents that actually clean your engine while you're driving.
Exactly. And if you use it regular, it can improve your car's performance.
You think they'd know that?
Of course you would.
Right, see you next week, lads.
Do you know where this goes?
Shell Advanced Petrol cleans your engine as you drive.
Thank you.
else quite hits the mark.
Boom, boom, akalaka laka boom.
You ever met anybody you didn't kill?
Well, I haven't killed you yet.
So I watch Miami Vice.
I want the dinosaur.
I want the dinosaur. Can't you understand? I have a whole relationship with someone else. I am very happy.
If your life's so damn complete, what were you doing with them?
Is this what you want to talk about, our imaginary love affair?
No nobility and poverty anymore.
Why do you need to wreck this company?
Because it's wreckable, all right?
You've had money and lost it. It's much worse than never having had it at all.
Satisfied? Now you should understand me. I don't play tennis, I don't drink mint juleps, and I don't give a damn about you, your family, or your dead cousin.
I'm Max Foley, Beverly Hills Billy Inspector.
Everybody stop what you're doing.
I'm a psychic. I'm a psychic phenomenon. Watch this. I don't know who you are, but watch this. Your name is, Lutz, right?
It's a Royal Mail train. Carries £1 million on a bank holiday weekend. And we're gonna nick it.
First.
No, we did one of your things already. We murdered the pimp and the fat man. Now it's time to do one of my things.
I think we've found our man.
Can't be serious.
If he can be of help, we'll use the devil himself.
Manchester United against Oldham, Manchester City away to Norwich, Everton's trip to Sheffield Wednesday. All that plus a complete roundup of the Rumbelows League Cup in Granada Soccer Night at 10:40.
This is Granada.
There now follows a party political broadcast by the Liberal Democrats.
Mrs. Thatcher called it a dead parrot.
John Major called it the dustbin for the protest vote.
The Labour Party called it a total waste of time.
And millions of real people called it the most exciting and encouraging development in British politics for about 50 years.
From Blackpool to Bournemouth, a year in the life of Britain's most dynamic political party. Here's the leader of the Liberal Democrats, Paddy Ashdown.
Just over a year ago, the Liberal Democrats met in Blackpool. In 2 weeks' time, we meet again in Bournemouth. And what a year it's been. I now know with absolute certainty that the ideas this party offers, the plans and the policies we've thought through and put forward, are beginning to be seen by you as the only real hope for this country in the longer term. There's a whole new world out there. A world that demands new ideas, new ways of doing things, and a new party to do them. By the year 2000, when people look back, I believe they'll see this last year as the year when British politics finally began to catch the mood and match the feelings of the British people.
September 1990, Blackpool. At the end of a highly successful conference, the newspaper Today wrote this.
Yesterday, Paddy Ashdown spelt out more unwelcome truths. We need to spend more money on education and the environment. We need electoral reform leading to proportional representation. To his credit, Mr. Ashdown made no secret of the fact that these things cost money. That, alas, makes the Liberal Democrats even more likely to be losers. What a commentary on our nation that telling the truth should spell disaster.
Yes, we did tell the truth. But no, it didn't spell disaster for us. It spelt instead the beginning of a huge new resurgence of understanding and support from the only people who matter. From you, the people of this country. Just look at this.
Between April 1990 and October 1990, just 1 month after the Blackpool conference, support for the Liberal Democrats more than doubled.
But in fact, out there in the real world, support was even greater than it seemed from the figures, as we very soon found out.
October 1990. David Bellotti of the Liberal Democrats wins Eastbourne in one of the most sensational by-election results in living memory.
To start with, the opinion polls had given us about 12% support. By the end of the campaign, when the people of Eastbourne had heard our plans and listened to our arguments and compared them with those of the two old parties, over 50% of them voted for David Bellotti and the Liberal Democrats.
The more the party told the truth, the more the people listened. And the more the people listened, the more support the party gained. It certainly didn't stop at Eastbourne. The more you knew about the Liberal Democrats, the more you liked their leader. Between the summer of 1990 and the spring of 1991, the personal popularity of Paddy Ashdown went from 27% to 53%. And then in March 1991 came Ribble Valley.
Again, they said we wouldn't do it. Again, at the start, the opinion polls gave us less than 12% support. Again, the Liberal Democrat candidate put our case, and the people of Ribble Valley listened, and they compared, and then they voted.
On Thursday, the 7th of March, 1991, the people of Ribble Valley voted in Liberal Democrat Mike Carr with no less than 48.5% of all votes cast.
So what did the two old parties have to say about that, then? Well, I expect you remember what they said. By-elections are different, they said. By-elections don't tell you anything, they said. It was all to do with the poll tax and Mrs. Thatcher, they said. You wait, they said. Those Liberal Democrats won't get anywhere when it comes to a proper national vote. Well, we didn't have to wait long.
May 1991. The local elections came with over 30 million people entitled to vote. At the start of the campaign, opinion polls suggested national support at about 15%. On polling day, the 2nd of May, the Liberal Democrats outperformed the most optimistic of forecasts. One in five voted for them, giving a national figure of 21%. Over 500 new seats, a greater gain than any other party.
So this remarkable year went on. Two more by-elections at Monmouth and Liverpool Walton provided still more evidence of what was happening. Against all the predictions, all over the country, people liked what they heard us saying, they liked what they saw us doing, and they voted for our candidates in ever-increasing numbers. And now, next month, in just a couple of weeks, we meet again as a party in Bournemouth. To congratulate ourselves? No. To celebrate? Well, maybe a bit. To sit back and relax? Absolutely not. Because however remarkable this last year has been, the year that's coming is the year that counts. It is my personal conviction that this coming year, this next general election, will be the most significant, the most important for every one of us in this country since 1945.
Changing Britain for good. That's what the Liberal Democrats are committed to doing, starting now.
What have you been telling us during this last year? You've been telling us that a government that can't get the economy right after 13 years is just not a government you want around any longer. You've been telling us that you don't think much of the Labour Party either. You've been telling us that a whole new world with great new opportunities and some new threats call for new and different ideas from a new and different party. You've been telling us that you just don't want any more fiddling around at the edges. You want to see some fundamental changes in the way this country is run. You're getting impatient. You want to hear the truth for once. You want Britain to change, soon and for good. And so do I. And so do the Liberal Democrats. And that's what we'll be seeing to when we all meet up in Bournemouth.
I'll give you just one fundamental reform that will give all our young people a far better education and a far better chance in life. 2 years, high quality education and training for all our young people after the age of 16. And if we need to ask for a penny on income tax to pay for it, we won't be afraid to ask you.
I'll give you just one fundamental reform that would bring sanity and stability to this country's government. It's called proportional representation. And what it means is simple. It means fair votes. It means, for the first time ever, every vote has an equal value. So wherever you live, and whoever you vote for, you'll be properly represented in the House of Commons.
I'll give you just one fundamental reform that would immediately check the scandalous way in which we exploit our environment. Tax all those who waste our limited natural resources, and tax them hard. And use the money those taxes raise to give people incentives to behave in ways that are better for the world we live in.
Fundamental reforms, because this next general election isn't just about the need to change the government, it's about the need to change our whole system of government, to do it fundamentally and to do it soon. As the events of this last year have shown, more and more of you want that, which is why more and more of you have thrown your support behind the Liberal Democrats, the only political party committed to such reform. It won't be easy. The two old parties are both against us. They've too much to lose. So we need not just your votes, we need your support, your membership, and yes, your money as well. The cause is a great one. Why not join us right now?
If you'd like to help the Liberal Democrats change Britain for good, or find out more about them, just dial 100 and ask for free phone Liberal Democrats. Or write to Paddy Ashdown, 4 Cowley Street, London SW1. That's free phone 100 or Paddy Ashdown, 4 Cowley Street, London SW1.